Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about type, the type tool, and the first three type tools on the toolbar: the type tool, the area type tool, and type on a path tool. First, we'll hit T to get to the type tool and click once. And as I mentioned up here, if you need to type a long string of text, do it in a text box, but for single clicking, that's the best for this type of shape. So let's just go ahead and create something. I want to highlight this and use my eyedropper tool to get this type. Or not. Sometimes you have to hide something and then you can click this type. Okay. I will unhide Option Command 3. To hide it, it's Command 3. This type path was interfering with my eyedropper tool. So I just hit it, and then I could easily click on this text to make this change to it, if all that makes sense. Okay, so we have to create something now. I want to just cut this. And to clear out of a text path, the best way to do it is Command Return. You can also hit Escape, and that will return you to your black arrow tool. So now I'll hit the T tool again and click once and then paste. And I'll hit Command Return and the I for eyedropper. And now we'll click this. Now this is an appearance that I built. So when I click on it, it doesn't want to show me the fills that are there. So if you Command Y, you can see it, but normally it doesn't have a fill or a stroke. So I'm going to create a quick graphic style with this. I have the appearance built here. It's two fills and one has been transformed a little bit. So I'm going to pull that up to graphic styles. And I do have a video about using appearance and graphic style together if you want to go watch that. I'll leave the link in my description. Okay, so let's click back on this hidden word with no fill. And now we'll click on that graphic style. And that's how we'll get that. Now, I'm going to do type change case to title case, and that will get us what we're looking for. When you're creating typographic shapes like these, usually for a header or something, it's best to just click once instead of putting that text in a type path, because that way you can easily resize it, you can change colors easily, you don't have to mess with that text box. Okay, so let's move these two things out of the way. And I want to show you the other way that you can use the type tool. I'm going to hit T again, and now we'll click and drag into a type box. I'm going to copy this, Command C, then Command Return. And now we'll highlight this box, hit T, click in there, and paste. And as you can see, this behaves a lot more like a paragraph. It will automatically wrap for you. You don't have to hit return. If you were to type here, it would just keep going off to the right. It wouldn't ever wrap the text because you're not telling it where to wrap it. So you would have to hit return. And you don't really want to hit return a lot if you can help it, unless you're actually typing a new paragraph. Now I'm going to start a new word and we'll just type sports here. I'll hit Command Return and go up here to my character palette. I'll just type in college. So as you can see, it's a sort of a sporty font. And I wanted to show you a few different things you can do quickly with type. First off, let's zoom in. That's the Z tool. And these are not really spaced the way I want them. These here look all right, but the space between the R and the T is a little too wide. So I'm going to hit Option and the left arrow key and just move that right back together. Now the whole thing looks like it could have a little less space, so let's Command Return. Now I have the whole thing selected, and I'll Option left click. And as you can see, that will space it out and adjust the tracking. Okay, now let's go up here. I wanna show you some different ways that you can warp this text. Let's go to Effect, Warp, and Arc. And we'll put the bend at about 22 is fine. This is really nice for t-shirt graphics, but we'll move on to an even better way of doing this, because as you can see, the S here is a little small on the bottom and large on the top, and that is not really the best case scenario unless you just like it like that. That'll be a tool we'll learn about here in a second. If you go in your appearance palette, you can click on this warp arc and change it to any other of the warp options. So you can get a lot of different effects. We'll hit the preview button so we can see what we're doing here. And change them all around the way we like them. That's a little weird. All right, I'm gonna put these back at zero. So it's kind of like word art, but it's a little, I think it looks better than word art. Since we as designers don't usually like word art very much, but it's good for t-shirt designs. Say okay. Now I want to show you another option with text. I'm going to shift and option drag this. Well, drag and then hold shift and option. And I'm going to throw this piece away. So now we just have the sports word. And with the M tool, I'm going to draw a rectangle. And then with the A tool, I'll highlight this dot and bring it down. And I'll highlight this dot and bring it up. I'm going to color this red so you can see a little better what we're doing. And I'm going to put it on top of this sports word. This is an envelope, and Illustrator will recognize it as an envelope if you tell it it's an envelope. And to do that, we have to highlight both, go to Object, and Envelope Distort, Make with Top Object. And as you can see, it has filled that space of the envelope that we just created. If we do Command Y, you can't see the word anymore, and that's because it's not editable right now. But if you go to Object, Envelope Distort, and Edit Contents, now we can continue typing in here. It will automatically do what it should. But as you can see, when we Command Y now, we don't have that envelope shape anymore. So you can switch back and forth between the Envelope Distort, Edit Envelope, depending on what you want to change. Let's do Command Y to get back to our normal view. I'm going to use the A tool and highlight that little point, and then we'll bring it all the way up here like this. So you can get some different effects with the envelope distort that you definitely couldn't get with the regular warp tool. You have to be really careful though, because it starts really distorting it in weird ways the more you play with it, so just watch out for that. All right, I'm going to go ahead and delete these, and we'll move on to the area type tool. The area type tool lets your text expand. It's kind of like having a text box, but it might be more like a text star. So first we have to draw a shape. I'm going to come here to the shape tool, and we'll get a polygon, and I'll just draw a polygon. All right. Now at this point, we'll go back to the area type tool, and I'm going to click right on the edge. You have to click right on the edge or it won't work. I just copied a bunch of bacon ipsum from the internet, and I'm just going to paste that in, Command V. And it's super huge, of course, so let's make it, we'll make it 12 point. And as you can see, this bacon ipsum is now forming inside the shape. It'll match whatever shape you've set. So as you can see, this side is not great. We can always center it, Shift Command C or Shift Control C, and we get a little more of that hexagon shape. So if we want to change this a little bit, we can use our A tool, select that point, and just move it any way we want to. So I'm going to use my N tool. And I'm going to start right here and end up here. And now we've got a smooth shape on that side and the text is flowing around it. Since Illustrator doesn't really have as robust of tools as InDesign for this kind of thing, this is one way you can get it to work. Let's delete that. Okay, and now finally we have the Type on a Path tool. And this one is very similar to the area type tool, but it goes around the edge of the path instead of inside it. Let's go back to our shape tools and choose a ellipse. And I'm just going to hold shift to make a perfect circle. Usually when I have a fill like this, I'll clear it by hitting the question mark button. And then we'll get back on our type on a path tool and I'll click right on the edge again. I'm going to type sports since we had talked about doing this a different way. And now we've got three little handles. We got this one, and I'll move this out a little bit. You can see what's going on. A line with a square, another line with a square, and then this little thin line here. The ones that'll move the text around the edge are these lines with a square. So I'm gonna grab one and move it, as you can see, like this. We'll leave this over here. And I want this to be centered, so I'll try to make it about even on both sides here. And now I'm going to increase this to get a text on a path, a pace-up arch. So now we have some really weird gaps in here. Let's clean those up. This is probably fine here, but let's get in between the P and the O, and option left click to get that a little closer. That's all right, and we'll do the same here and here. I'll copy this word and paste. And I'm gonna compare this to the effect, warp, and arc. We'll put it at 50. I'm gonna hit Command T to get to my character palette, and I'll just put these back at 0. All right, so as you can see, it's warping the top of this and the bottom to make that arc shape. But if you do a type on a path, you can get a perfect arc with no warping of your text. So I think this looks better. It really depends on what type of text and font you choose, which will look better. So you can just play around with those. All right, anyway, we'll delete this warp one and go with the paste up arch. We can do this. We can move this all the way around, upside down if we wanted to. Now, if you cross over, it will start coming out the other side. So a lot of times you'll get this little red box with a plus in it, and you don't want that. Just keep going one way or the other so it comes out right. I'm going to do Command R to get my rulers. And I'll pull a guide down because I want this to be the same on both sides so it's more centered looking. And now I'll pull this over so that both sides, this part and this part, lines up. So I'd be ready to go with a t-shirt if I wanted to make a t-shirt that said sports. Let's say I wanted it to be across the bottom like this. Right now we can just pull this middle handle down. You have to click right on it. And it is hard to get it perfect, but once you get it in there, then you can swing it down below. At this point, I would probably mess with the baseline shift, move that down a little bit so it has a little more space there. And then, of course, we can come in and move things closer and farther away using option right and left click. And this is still a little big. Let's make it a little smaller, holding shift, command, comma. Okay, and move that out just a little bit. These are some different ways that you can manipulate text. Next week, we'll cover the rest of the text tools. I hope this has been helpful for you. If you like this video, please click the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. And if you're having trouble or have any questions, just leave those in the comments section below. Thanks, guys.